Assalamualaikum and hi. Here, Madam Madihah binti Abdul Manan. Today, I'm going to discuss a few questions about a rotational of rigid body. Let's check it out. So, here is the first question. Jom kita baca soalan bersama-sama. Given that S, VA and F are parameters associated with linear motion, copy and complete table 1 with their corresponding parameters in a rotational motion and their relationship. So here we have three columns. The first column is linear motion. The second column is rotational motion. And the third column is for relationship between linear motion and rotational motion. For linear motion, we have S stand for displacement. Untuk rotational motion, we know that rotational motion rotate involve the angle. So here we have the theta stand for angular displacement. So the relationship between these two are S equals to R theta. For linear motion, V stand for velocity, but for rotational motion, we have omega stand for angular velocity, and the relationship is V equals to R omega. For a linear motion, we have A stand for acceleration, and in rotational motion, we have alpha stand for angular acceleration, and the relationship is A equals to R alpha. Last but not least is F stand for force for linear motion, and we have R stand for torque for rotational motion, and their relationship is tau equals to Rf sin theta. Okay, sekarang saya akan tuliskan unit bagi parameter-parameter di bawah. For linear motion, the unit for S or displacement is meter. The unit for velocity is meter per second. The unit for acceleration is meter per second square. This is the unit, okay? For force, the unit is Newton. Okay, untuk rotational motion, the unit for theta, the unit for theta is radian. The unit for omega is radian per second. The unit for alpha is radian per second square. And the unit for tau is Newton meter. Okay, untuk menggunakan semua jenis equation yang terdapat dalam bahagian kolom relationship ini, kita mestilah menggunakan unit SI. For example, radius here, the unit for radius is meter. The unit for force here is Newton, and the unit for theta here is degree. Okay, sin theta. Okay, up here, the unit here is radian. But the unit for sin theta, the theta here, the unit should be in degree. For example, theta equals to 90 degrees. Okay, so kita teruskan dengan soalan yang kedua. Okay, so this is the second question. Let's read the question together. So Ariana is pushing a huge Lazy Susan on the table as in figure 1. She exerts a force of 4 Newton perpendicular to the edge of the 3 kg Lazy Susan, which has a 1 meter radius. Calculate first the moment of inertia of the Lazy Susan. Second, the angular acceleration when the Lazy Susan is being pushed. And the third question is the new angular acceleration when a jar with mass 1 kg is put on the Lazy Susan 0.5 meter away from the center. So here in figure 1, we can see a table. And we have a huge Lazy Susan on the table. So when the Ariana is pushing the Lazy Susan will rotate. So in this case, we have radius for the Lazy Susan. Okay, radius daripada tengah sampai ke hujung. And then Ariana is pushing the Lazy Susan with force per Newton at the edge of the Lazy Susan. So the theta here is 90 degree. 90 degree. The theta between R and F is 90 degree. So we go to the first question. Okay, so this one theta is 90 degree. Okay, so before we start to answer the question, first we have to write down all the information that we get from the question before. So first we have F equals to 4 Newton. The mass of the lazy Susan is given by 3 kg. The radius of the lazy Susan R here is 1 meter. And the angle between F and R is theta equals to 90 degree. Okay, now the first question asks you to calculate the moment of inertia of the lazy Susan. So, jika kita lihat dalam buku nota, kita ada jumpa bentuk silinder. Ada dua rumus. So, yang mana satu kita nak pilih? Ya, kita pilih yang kedua. Okay. Yang kedua, ini. Kenapa? Kerana Lazy Susan is a solid cylinder or box. Okay, dia tidak ada hollow di tengah-tengah. Tak ada lubang kat tengah dia. So, kita anggap dia sebagai solid cylinder of box. Okay, so kita dah letakkan rumus. Kita masukkan value-value yang kita ada. So M from the mass of the lazy Susan. So kita nak kira inertia of the lazy Susan. So the mass and the radius here must come from the mass and radius from the lazy Susan. Okay, now after we substitute all the value by using the calculator and we get ourselves 1.5 kg meter square. Okay, next question. So, here is the next question. We want to calculate the angular acceleration with the lazy Susan is being pushed. So, we want to calculate the theta. So, by using this equation, total tau equals to I alpha. So, this is in rotational motion. Kalau in rotational motion eh? Rotational motion. Okay, kalau dalam linear motion, kita pakai apa? Kita gunakan total F equals to MA, di mana F analogi dengan tau, mass analogi dengan I dan A analogi dengan alpha. Sebab tu kita dapat rumus seperti ini. Okay, now we have the equation. For rotational motion, total tau equals to I alpha. So we know that the moment of inertia for a lazy Susan kita dah kira tadi. Okay, so kita tahu juga bahawa tau equals to RF sin theta. Takkan? Okay, kita masukkan nilai. Okay, so R di sini 1 meter. Force exerted on the lazy Susan by Ariana just now is 4 Newton. The sine theta, kita tengok kat sini theta kita 90 darjah. So, sine 90 degree. Okay, I kita dah dapat from the previous question 1.5 dan alpha. So, by using the calculator, okay, we will get ourselves 2.67 radian per second square. Okay, very easy. Okay, pilih rumus yang betul, terus dapat jawapan. Okay, next question. Okay, next question, you are going to calculate the new angular acceleration when a jug with mass 1 kg is put on the lazy Susan 0.5 meter away from the center. Okay, so kita nak cari angular acceleration yang baru bila kita letakkan jug kat sini. Kita letak jug eh. So, jug ini, telah saya letak kat sini jug ni. Ni jug kat sini. Jug. Okay, jug ini cantik. So, jug ini adalah R dia. Di sini, R dia ni adalah 0.5 meter. Kalau R dia, radius adalah 1 meter. So, jug ini dah ada di atas lazy Susan. So, bila Ariana tolak, kita akan tolak lazy Susan itu bersama jug tersebut. Oleh itu, dia akan menjadi lebih berat. So, kita ada dua benda nak tolak bersama-sama. So, by using the equation, total tau equals to I alpha. So, the I now adalah moment initial from the lazy Susan plus moment initial from the jug. Okay, ini jug ni. So, same force exerted by the Ariana. Rf sin theta. So, R is the radius of the lazy Susan. Because the force exerted is actually at the edge of the lazy Susan. Okay, the edge of the lazy Susan. Kita tak tolak jug, kita tolak lazy Susan eh. Tapi jug itu di atas lazy Susan. So, kita tolak, kita dapat Rf sin theta. Okay, Rf sin theta, kita tolak dia. Okay, ni. Tolak kat sini. So, R ini, R is from axis of rotation to the force applied. Axis of rotation to the force applied, R. Dan kita punya F, macam ni eh. F. Ikut jarak dia. So kita dapat macam ni lah. So theta dia adalah 90. Okay. Moment initial for lazy Susan kita dah kira. Now we want to calculate the moment initial for the jug. Okay. MR square ingat. Kita anggap jug ni seperti partikel. So daripada rumus MR square. Sebab ada satu jug sahaja eh. Okay. Kita masukkan semua value dalam persamaan kita. Okay, by using the calculator. Okay, dekat sini. Kita masukkan semua nilai-nilai yang ada by using the calculator. Kita akan dapat nilai alpha kita. Iaitu 2.29 radian per second square. Ingat eh? Beza eh? Di sini, mass untuk jug. Radius untuk jug. Okay. Radius eh. Radius di mana jug itu berada daripada center. Okay. Yang depan sini adalah lazy Susan. This one ini pun di atas lazy Susan. Kenapa? Sebab lazy Susan itu yang kita gerakkan. The Ariana is pushing the lazy Susan. But on the lazy Susan we have the jug. So actually the Ariana is pushing the lazy Susan plus the jug together. Okay. Now, kita pergi kepada soalan yang seterusnya. So, this is the third question. So, basically in your tutorial, you only have one mass. One mass. Now, we have two masses here. Macam mana nak kira? Senang sahaja. So, first we have to read the question. So figure 2 shows 2 kg and 5 kg blocks is hung by a light rope, meaning that it is massless, right? Look, right? Light rope ini bermaksudnya dia adalah massless lah. Kita anggap dia massless. Tali eh, rope, tali yang massless. Bukan pulley, tali. Which is wound around a pulley of radius 30 cm. The moment of inertia of the pulley is given by 1.5 kg meter square. Calculate the angular acceleration of the pulley and the linear acceleration of the object. Okay, so first kita ambil dulu 2 kg sebagai mass 1 dan 5 kg sebagai mass 2. Okay, senang. Satu mass 1, satu mass 2. Kemudian kita tulislah dekat atas ni all the information that we get from the question. For example, radius of the pulley is 30 cm. Convert into meter. Make sure you convert all the units into SI unit. The moment initial for the pulley is given 1.5 kg meter square. So now we want to calculate the angular acceleration of the pulley. First, we have to consider all the forces exerted on the pulley and the masses and on the rope and how the system is moving. Okay, jadi kita tahu bahawa mass 5 kg adalah lebih berat pada mass 2 kg. Jadi mestilah mass 5 kg ini akan jatuh ke bawah dan mass 2 kg objek itu akan terangkat ke atas dan pulley itu mesti rotate. Okay. Disebabkan oleh graviti, tarikan graviti. So, kita dapatlah mass objek 5 kg itu akan jatuh turun ke bawah toward the center of the earth. Okay, and then the pulley will rotate ikut arah angular acceleration itu ikut arah acceleration. Dan acceleration untuk 2 kg itu akan naik ke atas. Barulah dia tally, naik ke atas, pusing troli, pusing ni turun ke bawah. So, ini dia akan naik macam ni lah. Pusing ya. Berpusing. Okey. Ni pusing kat sini. Lagi ada pusing macam tu. Okey. Sekarang kita tengok apakah jenis-jenis force exerted on the system. Okay, for mass 1, we have T1 and weight 1. For mass 2, we have T2 and weight 2. Okay. So, pada puli kita, lihat eh. Kita ada dua tempat tali, sini satu, sini satu. So, tali yang sama. Tali yang sama tetapi mass kita ada moment inertial. So, dia kena overcome puli itu dulu untuk tarik. Okey. Baru sebelah sini boleh tertarik. Sebelah 2 kg mass ni. Jadi di sebelah 2 kg mass tali sama. T1, T1, weight 1. Okey. Sebelah tali pada 5 kg mass kita letakkan T2, T2. So weight adalah weight 2. So kat sini kita bahagikan kepada 3 sistem. Sistem mass 1, sistem puli dan sistem untuk mass 2. Next, we have to draw a free body diagram. We start with the free body diagram for mass 1. Okay, tengok betul-betul T1 ke atas. Jangan letak dua-dua T ya. T1, T2 letak sekali. Tak boleh. Kita kena pilih. So, T1 tension mesti keluar daripada objek. Okay. Tension untuk puli keluar daripada objek puli. Okay, so dekat sini kita dah dapat. Okay. Kita, total Fy equals to Ma. Tengok sini. Ini parallel dengan sini. So positif. Acceleration parallel dengan T1 eh. Weight 1 opposite direction. Parallel juga tetapi in opposite direction. Acceleration dan T1 parallel to each other but in same direction. So kalau same direction, positive, opposite direction, negative. Itu je. Okay. Gantikan. Rearrange the equation properly. And then substitute the value M1, 2. Gravity 9.81. Okay. Kita tahu bahawa A equals to R alpha. Gantikan dalam persamaan. R datangnya daripada puli. So kita masukkan radius puli 0.3. Okay, so we get ourselves the first equation. Okay, next. For the second system. Okay, we draw free body diagram for mass 2. Like this. Okay, so here by using the equation total F equals to MA. Nak letak Y boleh, tak nak letak Y pun tak apa. Let's just letak Y. Okay, so here we know that the acceleration here is parallel and in opposite direction with weight 2. Okay, the acceleration is parallel to T2 but opposite direction. So, jadi negatif. Okay, tuliskan equation weight 2 sama arah tolak T2 opposite direction with the acceleration equals to M2A because now we are considering the mass from 5 kg mass 2. Okay. So weight equals to Mg, weight 2 equals to M2G. Okay, substitute the value. Okay, make sure the mass 2 is 5 kg. And then we know that A equals to R alpha. Okay, then we substitute into the equation and then R equals to 0.3 meter. Okay, then we get ourselves a second equation like this. So we have T1, T2, alpha. We have 3 unknown but 2 equation. We cannot solve the problem. The unknown should be same. Equation. Contohnya kita ada dua unknown, kita kena ada dua equation. Kita ada more equation, more equation than unknown, kita boleh jawab soalan. But if we have more unknown, then more unknown, then we cannot answer the question. Okay, so here we have three unknowns, tapi dua equation. So kita kena cari satu lagi persamaan. Okay, jadi kita cari persamaan untuk puli pula. So ini adalah persamaan untuk puli. Okay, nampak tak? Sini salin dia balik. Okay, salin balik saja. Jadi kita gunakan equation tau, total tau equals to I alpha. So di sini kita ada dua T from the two ropes. Okay, T1, T2. Okay, so kita kena ada tau lah, tau kita positif ke tau kita negatif. So kita tahu bahawa total tau, sorry, kita tahu vector tau equals to vector R cross vector F. So macam kita nak buat, kita ambil ni dulu. Ingat, ingat eh. Arah untuk arah arah atau direction for R is from axis of rotation to the force applied. Nampak arrow saya tulis ni. Jadi kita lukis sini eh, ini daripada sini. Ni. Okey, kita lukis R T ke bawah. So T kita adalah force. So kita lukis R cross force. Vector R cross vector force iaitu T1. So kita tengok rotate, arah rotate alpha is susah. Belah sini ni sudah rotate macam ni. So this is your alpha. Macam ni alpha. Sama arah? Tidak, opposite direction. So tau kita negative 1. Macam tu je. Okay, untuk sebelah sini pula, tengok ini eh. Ni. Ni. So R from axis of rotation to the force applied. Arah R. T ikut. Ikut sini eh. Ha, ni ke bawah. So 2. 2 eh. Vector R cross vector F. F kita dah tension. Second. Tension 2 eh. Ini. Sama tak dengan arah A? Bukan A, sorry, alpha. Sama arah. So ini akan jadi positif tau 2. So kita letakkan dalam equation kita positif tau 2, negatif tau 1. Kita tahu tau equals to RF sin theta. Okay, kita nampak dekat sini theta dia 90 darjah. Theta 90 darjah. Theta 90 darjah. Theta 90 darjah. Sin 90 sama dengan 1. Sini eh. 1. Okey, masukkan nilai R 0.3 T2 tolak 0.3 T1 equals to I. Alpha I kita adalah 1.5 given. Already given in the question. Okay, so we get the question. The equation number 3. Okay, so kita dah ada T1, T2 alpha, 3 unknown dan kita ada 3 equation. So now kita boleh jawab soalan. So kita ambil equation 1, equation 2, substitute into equation 3. Okay, next. Okay, kita dah masukkan. Okay. Nah, kita masukkan nilai, kita kira sampailah kita dapat jawapan. So by using the calculator, we get ourselves 4.15 radian per second square. So this is the answer. Okay, last but not least, second question, the linear acceleration of the object. Okay, so the linear acceleration of the object is from one, question one, we get the answer for alpha. So kita boleh cari A equals to R alpha. Okay. Masukkan nilai, terus dapat jawapan. So untuk soalan ini, kalau soalan minta cari tension 1 and tension 2, kita boleh guna equation 1 and equation 2, substitute all the value that we get before, then we get we can get ourselves the answer for D1 and D2. Okay, for a lazy Susan, soalan nombor 2 tadi, selain contoh lazy Susan, dia juga menggunakan konsep yang sama untuk turn table dan juga kita boleh gunakan konsep yang sama untuk merry-go-round. Okay, merry-go-round juga adalah menggunakan konsep yang sama dengan konsep lazy Susan tadi. Okay, setakat itu sahaja pembelajaran kita pada hari ini. Harap dia berguna untuk UPS dan juga untuk anda semua menjawab assignment. Okay, akhir kata, sedikit pesanan buat kita semua. Bila kamu tidak tahan penatnya belajar, maka kamu akan menanggung peritnya kebodohan. Itulah kata-kata daripada Imam Asy-Syafi'i. Okay, till then. Terima kasih. Ingat, anda berusaha, anda pasti akan berjaya. Bye-bye.